I'm Aaron Fletcher.
I'm Christian Craig.
I'm Hunter Lawrence.
Josh Maladay.
I'm Cameron McAdoo.
I'm Justin Brayton.
Hey, I'm Marvin Muskan.
I'm Malcolm Stewart.
I'm Jalen Ferrangis, and I choose Ogio.
And I choose Ogio.
I choose Ogio.
I choose Ogio.
How was it tonight?
Oh, it's a really tough night. It was my first home race to really ever have. I mean, Daytona's home, but Tampa's kind of like more of a home race. And the day was going really good for me. I started the tone, or I set the tone really well in free practice. And first time qualifier, I made an adjustment to my bike, and it was not in the right direction. It was all on me though. Changed it back, and for the final qualifier, I ended up P9, I believe. So I was pretty stoked on that, because qualifying is something I normally struggle in. 10th overall, going to the gate, I was really confident, and we worked so many starts this week. The team crushed it for me, and actually ripped a really good start, like third or fourth, and it only lasted for like three corners. I just went to the right out of the main line, and it was just slick, and just caught wheel spin, and end over end, I win. I had a really tough hit, but went to A-Stars, I got taped up, and I tried to line up for the LCQ, and it was just, I couldn't ride. I'm not gonna sit out there and roll around the track for no reason. So I did the first section, and I knew I was not right, so pulled off, and so disappointing, man. I started the season strong last weekend in Houston, and wanted to keep it going, and I had a good day going, but you know, everything happens for a reason, and my team crushed it today, and it was really cool to have a lot of friends and family here, so we'll bounce back. I'm gonna go back to Charlotte, get healed up, and I'm gonna do everything I can to be in the gate in Dallas.
It was solid. Got a kind of a bad start in the main event, but I was pretty smoked from the LCQ. Much love to Marsh. That was an aggressive move, but hopefully, or I'm sure he would've done the same thing to me, so it is what it is.
Cool. Hey, been building and building these last couple weeks. Really turning into a good Supercross guy. So how is it after two races right now?
Yeah, it's going good. Last weekend I had a little bike malfunction, but it's all part of it. And then like, yeah, this weekend I went to the LCQ, which is not ideal. So I was pretty tired for the main event. So hopefully Dallas, I think it is next for me. And hopefully get through the heat race and then focus on the main event and execute a good start and get out front.
It was okay. The LCQ actually kind of wore me out a little bit. I came from pretty far back. So, I managed to get 16th on the night and with the tip over. So it's all good. So, yeah.
This 250 class is something right now. It goes a lot of different ways all night, from the heat race to the last lap of the main event.
Yeah, it's a tough field right now. There's a lot of fast guys and a lot of factory guys out there. So to be a privateer and stuff, it's nice to get in the main event. And hopefully next week, or I guess weekend off for us, hopefully we can get in the top 15 and try to get around that top 10 spot. So, but yeah.
Yeah, no, today was pretty frustrating. Super frustrated with my riding right now, and yeah, just have to be better at this point. The bike's good, team's good, and just really just falls on me right now. So yeah, no, ended up 14th in the main event, which is not good. I think I was running like 9th, crashing a sand turn, and yeah, just super frustrated right now. Just gotta be better.
Is it like small mistakes, or is it like a lack of riding because of the time off, or is it something you can pinpoint, or do you just know I gotta be better?
It's probably a little of everything, you know, lack of riding. Obviously we got more time on the bike this past week, which was really good. We made a lot of good progress with the bike. I just think it's just going to be seat time, and yeah, luckily we got a weekend off, you know, when they go to Oakland, then we got the Dallas Triple Crown. So yeah, it's got to go back to work and get better for that.
Today ended on a good note. I struggled in qualifying all day. I was good everywhere besides the whoops. And then obviously coming into the night show, I was not happy that I qualified 20th. I'm better than that. And Yoshi from Enzo made a little adjustment and came into the heat, got a good start. Crushed the whoops for me. I was stoked on that. Ended up 6th. And then, obviously coming out of heat is way better than having to go to LCQ. So went into the main, okay start, not the greatest for me, but it was all right. And ended up the night on getting 11th. So first two rounds, I went 12-11, so it was progress. And 10th was right there, and my pace, I know I can be like 8th. So I just need to get the fitness up a little bit, and we're gonna take full advantage of this time off until we go to Arlington. So we got a weekend off, so it's time to dig. I'm excited. It's time to dig.
Hey, can I ask you what's on the ground next to us right now?
Oh, yeah. I fully exerted myself in the main, and I threw up.
That happens.
Yeah. Hey, can't say I didn't give it my best effort.
It was really good, man. I was sixth on the heat, and then I fell, and I was eighth, and then I cut the track a little bit, and I got that one position, and they put me 10th, so I had to go to the LCQ, and I was like, I have to win this. So I got a really good start, then I just put my head down, put lap times down, and, you know, I went to the main. I got a really good start. I almost failed because I got contact with another rider, but I failed twice, and then I was like, man, I have to get back, and I finished 10, and I'm really happy with the results. Like, we've been working really hard, and yeah, that was my day.
I love that whip. That was sick.
Thank you so much. Yeah, I was so happy, and you know, I did it for the crowd.
I was definitely stepping in the right direction for me. We got P9 in the main. My start in the heat was awesome, so that was good. I kind of struggled throughout practice. The team's been working hard. Like, we've actually been making a lot of changes throughout the day, throughout the weeks. I had a little hiccup before the season, so I lost about 5 to 6 weeks of training. And that was, you know, switching teams and bikes and things like that. It was tough for me. It kind of kept it on the DL. So just playing catch up a little bit. But tonight was, I felt a lot more comfy. Like, throughout the day, we continued to make changes. We made a pretty big change in the main, suspension wise, and actually, like, the guys nailed it, I felt like. So it was a step in the right direction. Didn't get the greatest start, kind of worked my way up a little bit, but no, I feel good. I'm excited to be back, you know, riding the Honda, back with the Phoenix boys, and then having Heath Harris in my mechanic. Like, it's awesome because he races, he still can crush it, but also, like, we're good buddies, and then he helps me throughout the day as well. So he's been a big part of making this happen. And just everything. Like, I'm having fun. Today was, like I said, a big step in the right direction. I know I keep saying that, but for me, it was. And still not where I want to be, but we're going to continue to keep getting better. So I'm excited. We get a weekend off, so that's 2 weeks of training and testing, and then go to the Triple Crown in Arlington and put some heat down.
Hey, how was it in the main event, like, halfway through when the rain started?
Yeah, I actually was kind of just like going through tear-offs, and then once the rain started, I was like, dude, I better spare my tear-offs a little bit. And then, like, in the sand, you'd get blasted. So I was actually pretty good till about 3 to 4 laps to go. I ran out of tear-offs, and then at that point, I was just kind of doing the wipe. And the track did start getting a little bit slick, but overall, it wasn't too bad. Like, you still do all the obstacles and stuff, so it was good. Honestly, I'm just thankful that the rain held off for the most part and it wasn't just a complete mutter. So overall, I'd say it was a good weekend.
Yeah, pretty good. Happy with the result. Overall, was another good night. 3 in the heat, last weekend. And 6 in the main, a little bit better, one place better. I messed up the first lap. I crashed in the sand. Crashed in the sand, and I was in P2 actually, passing in P2, I crashed in the sand. So I struggled a little bit the first 2-3 laps. I went out in the whoops after, missed a lot of position and a lot of time actually. I was quite back, and I went back to 6. I passed Moziman in the last lap, so he had a small tip over in the sand, I think. Passed him in the last lap, finished 6. Overall, it was a good day, actually.
Cool. How was riding that sand section with Supercross suspension?
Really difficult. You know, like, a lot of people say, yeah, coming from Europe, the sand. But the bike is way different. The shock is actually so hard that we can't load the bike, you know. The bike is pushing a little bit, and it's a lot different than riding with motocross suspension than Supercross suspension in the sand.
Oh, it was super good. Qualifying and practice, a little bit of practice went well, actually. Third place track was very good. And then, like, qualifying was a struggle for me. Just didn't really feel good all day in qualifying. Couldn't get in a good flow for some reason. But then heat race came around, and first lap I felt good. Got the whole shot and rode an awesome race. I felt super smooth. Track was awesome. Bike was awesome. Super proud of that. And yeah, I ended up winning my first heat race, which was a surreal moment for me. Finally get another win. So I've been waiting on it for a little bit. I didn't think it'd come this soon. I really didn't think a win would come this soon, even a heat race win. So I'm super happy for it. And main event was good, had a good start. I think came around the first turn second. And then it got pinched off in the second turn by J-Mart a little. He got ran high though, so it's not his fault. And then locked in, smooth laps, carried a good momentum around the whole track, and ended up fourth.
Cool. Hey, what was it like when the rain started coming down halfway through? Because that whole track had to change.
Yeah, definitely. The rain, it will catch you off guard. The Tampa, this dirt is really slick underneath. Like, it'll catch you quick. Like Smith fell in the heat race. It just catches you quick. You don't see it coming in the front wheel tuck. So when it started getting a little muddy, I just found that cushion off the edge a little bit of like the cement, like the hard pack landing. It's not cement, but like the blue groove. And I could find the cushion and ride the cushion, and that was the best for me. So just, I feel like when it starts raining, you just gotta have good line choice.
Cushion talk, I like that. Real dirt track guy.
Yeah.
No, honestly, great fun. I just like being up on that podium. It's so fun. We had a lot more stressful day today than last week. Last week everything seemed to go quite smoothly. This week the first free practice went great. I went P1 in that, so I was like pretty pumped on that. And then time training was up and down. I got held up like really bad with people in the sand. Like wasn't. I felt good, but I just didn't get clean laps, and I was like, oh, I was getting a bit frustrated. And I thought, what am I getting frustrated for? Like, I just want to be in the top five in time training. Like, I'm happy. Top three gate pick for the heat race literally is prime time for me. I'm golden. So had to have a little recheck, and then the heat race we thought it was going to be a lot wetter than what it was. So we went. Don't know how to word this, but we went like a direction with the bike. That was safer for the mud, and it wasn't. It was perfect. It was prime out there, and I was definitely struggling in the heat race. So then we went back to our morning setup for the main. Start was great, like great to be up there. Like everything was good, and then it started raining about midway through, and I could feel she was getting a little hot under me, and the clutch was going a bit in the sand. I was like, oh, she's. It was hard. It was like an outdoor race, honestly. Like the sand section was hard on the bike. So for us, for the team, for a relatively small team, you know, Firepower Honda, they've put together. I've got such a great group of guys. Like we've put together a bike that is competitive. Okay, we got a couple of teething issues here and there, but man, we were on the podium. It's fantastic. I think we can. We can try and fight for one of these wins, you know, coming up soon. I'm hoping we can go back to the drawing board this week, iron out a few little things, and have a weekend off, and come back for Arlington. Honestly, I couldn't be happier. Two podiums, it's fantastic. I'm kind of sat here going, oh man, I want more. But man, if you'd have told me 3 weeks ago that I was going to get two podiums the first two rounds, I'd have been over the moon. Like this is fantastic. And for Yariv back in Australia, the whole crew. It's fantastic. They've done such a good job. Like Marty, even FC, like Mike Hayes, my suspension guy, such, like my bike is so solid. Like I feel really good and really consistent, and it's the best I've ever felt in Supercross. So I'm really enjoying my time, and every race I'm having fun, and we'll see what the rest of the season brings and see what happens.